Hey, I'm Ben Atkins, and
I'm Tabitha Thomas.
We are here from AdLab. It's your premier source for how to start a Facebook marketing agency from your home. Today, we're going to be talking about what to do when you have a potential client that you really like, but you have to walk away from, and how to get them back. You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Okay, so this is a difficult one because it's always hard for me when I fall in love with somebody that I want to work with and then I have to walk away because they either don't have the money at the time in their budget or maybe they're
wrong
just
timing.
There's so many things. So typically how this happens and how this goes down is we'll walk in and we'll set up a trial with the client and we'll have, you know, gone through that and we get to the point to where we're actually pitching our, you know, the package we want to present, and they just aren't ready for it because of timing, budget, whatever, and we have to actually walk away. The key is you want to walk away
gracefully.
Gracefully. Because if you actually like them, it means that you're probably going to be doing business with them in the future. You had a good back and forth. So what do you do? How do you actually set this up so that a client that is ideal and perfect and that you can help will come back to you? How do you add that extra little bit of pressure to get them over the edge without trying to push them over the edge and it seeming that way? So this is the ballgame, and you were actually really good with this when I first met you and I wasn't doing the online marketing thing. So the big thing that you have to realize is when you go in and you fall in love with somebody and they're ready to go and everything seems good, all signs are pointing there, but then they have to walk away, you need to say, I understand, that's cool. I'll be checking back in with you sometime, and I appreciate you sitting down and meeting with us.
That's it.
Walk away. That's number one. That is a graceful walk away that anybody that's doing business out there that is reasonable can relate to.
Yeah.
So you left it good. They were left with a good feeling. You were left with a good feeling, and we're good. So here's the trick. Here's the trick. This is where things get good. 2 weeks later, you're going to go back into their office, and you are going to say, so listen, I've got another person in your area. You would consider them a competitor. Yeah, and they are wanting to sign up for the trial. They are wanting to sign up for the service. Before I went through with this, and I'm probably about a week out or so with working with them, before we go through and we sign the contract, I wanted to check with you and make sure that it's okay because I really enjoyed, you know, talking with you, and, you know, I like to be above board with everything.
Out of courtesy to you, I want to make sure that we're still good.
Yeah. Simple. And when you go in that way, a couple key things are going to happen. And number one, you get a really good sense if this was the person that you thought they were from how they react to you. So what's going to happen? The first thing that's going to happen is they're going to say, you know, that's totally cool. I'm not going to hold you back from what you want to do. If you need to go in and do that, we can't work with you right now, even though we'd love to, go right ahead. So that's one. And that's still, I'm like, I want to go back and work with them eventually if they respond that way.
Yeah.
Second, they're going to give you this line. Well, actually,
I was just going to call you.
Yeah. And that's the line that you're going to hear a lot of
times. I'm so glad you came back in. I was going to call you.
Yeah. And so we get that a lot. I was going to call you. I was really thinking about it and I wanted to work with you. And what you've effectively done is you've used scarcity. You've put this in front of them in a way that says, hey, we had a good thing going. Something was hanging you up. It wasn't me. It was you. Jump over the fence. And you're giving them sort of that nice, let's do it now without being that pushy sales person that we all hate. Yeah. So, like I said, super, super easy way that you can go in. You can have somebody that you fall in love with and they fell in love with you, but they just couldn't close the deal. And you can see one more time if you can make it work. And either way, you walk out of that office
feeling good.
Yeah, feeling really good. And that is a masterful way to make sure that if they sign up with you, they're happy. If they don't sign up with you, they're happy. And it's somebody that is still in your lead flow that you can go back to. So,
yeah.
Hopefully, guys, you enjoyed it. Like I said, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And as always, you can find us at
adlabblog.com.
Yes. And hope you enjoyed this one. We'll talk with you soon.